Today we're going to talk about how to install the TMC5160 on the Bigtree Tech Octopus version 1.0. Now there's a couple of things I need to talk about. First of all, the steppers. So they're basically written kind of incorrectly on the board. They're generic, but this will be your X stepper, your Y stepper, your Z stepper, your E0 stepper, your E1 stepper, your E2 stepper, your E3 stepper, and your E4 stepper. In this case, we need to know that the enable pin is located right here on all the steppers so that we place these correctly. And these are a higher power stepper, so they're slightly different. So I'm going to zoom in on one so you can see. So what you can see is the one on the left actually has cooling fins on it. And the other one, I left them off so you could see the top of the board. Now the enable pin in this case is actually located in the bottom left-hand corner in this case with that little white square. That's going to be important when we hook it up. And also, when you run these, you want to run them with an automatic fan. And I'll include a tutorial in that in my playlist that I think is already there, but I'll give you a link to the playlist so you can review for yourself. So in order to actually set this up, I'm going to show you the diagram of what it looks like. So inside here, the enable pin is going to be right here. It's also going to be here for the next stepper, but you notice that the silkscreen on the board says motor 0. That was what I was talking about. Motor 0 in this case is your X stepper, and then it follows that pattern. So what we want to do in a moment is actually go over to VS Code and set that up. So what we'll need to do is actually open up VS Code in a moment. But what I'm going to show you first is that in our downloads folder, I already have it here, but I'm going to delete it for a second. And then I'm going to show you how to extract it. Now, this is a recent download, so the extraction might seem different. But keep in mind, this version is actually from the 9th of July, so it's probably 2.0.9.1. So I'm going to extract that. This is going to take a few moments. And then when that finishes, we'll actually bring up VS Code and we'll work with that. So this is what VS Code currently looks like. And so to set this up, what we're going to need to do is actually click on the Explorer to open the file. And so I'll click here, then I'll click on Open Folder. And the next thing I'll do is I'll actually go to the Downloads folder, the Marlin folder, and then the next Marlin folder. And this is still populating, so it'll be ready in a second. So let's click on Select Folder. Now that that's open, what we're going to have to do is obviously set our default environment. And by setting that, what I mean is that we're going to need to know what chipset we're working with. And one of the important things to understand about our chipset is that we're going to need to find it. So I'll show you the technique that I use. So I'm going to go over to the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h, and I'm going to search on Octopus. And our board right here is the 1.1 version. So we're going to copy that. And when we copy that, we're also going to note the chipset, which is over here, which is STM32. Let me give you a little bit better visual of this. It's STM32F44. So now that we know that information, we're going to minimize core and source and go to configuration.h, and we're going to search on motherboard. Inside here, it's still on the default RAM, so we're going to paste our version over it. Then we're going to change the serial port from 0 to -1, And to set up the actual stepper, what we need to do is search on A4988, and that'll bring us to stepper types. Now we're only doing the X stepper in this case, so we're going to look for the TMC5160, and we're going to copy that and paste it right here. Now down below, there will be something that you may need to modify depending upon your taste and preference. And that's going to be the default axis steps per unit. And I'll show you how to deal with that right now. So if you go over to the configuration advanced.h and you search on 800, it may be a couple deep, it'll bring you to the actual setup for the current. So currently this is set for root mean square current. Usually the average is pretty good of 800, but you may or may not need to modify that. But you will need to modify resistor sense. So that's going to be 0.075. So now that you have that set up, you have to set this up for SPI. And SPI is serial peripheral interface. It's a way of connecting to your stepper through wires and software in order to communicate better. So what we're going to do is we're going to search on, I believe it's called Software SPI or TMC Use Software SPI. So I'm going to do a Control/ to remove the comment so we can enable it. We also have to enable TMC debug for a reason I'll show you in a minute. So it's TMC_debug, and that'll bring us to the debug status monitor. We're gonna need this for G codes later on, like M122. So we're gonna search on the next one because there's two. And we're gonna remove the comment for this as well with the slash and control button at the same time. Now that we have that configured, we can go back and actually look at the 800, and I'll show you what's going on here. So up here with the X stepper, currently the steps per or X microsteps are 16. That correlates to 80. If you were to change this to 160, you would need to change the other value over here to 32. If you were to change it to 320, you would need to change this value down here to 64. And you can do this all the way up to 256th of a step. So now that we understand that, what we're going to do is set this up to compile. So we're going to go to platformio.ini, and we need to set our default chipset. And because we're using a special chipset, we need to go to the ini folder. Then we need to find the STM32F, and inside here we're going to search on Octopus, and that'll bring us to our actual definition of the environment. So we'll copy that, then we'll go back to platformio.ini, and we'll paste that over the Mega 2560. So now that we have that all set, we do need to clean out our .pio build folder. Right now it currently has the Mega 2560, so I'm going to click on the little garbage can down here for clean, and that'll remove it from the folder so that we can start from scratch. Next, we need to click on the checkbox, and by doing that, it will start the build. Now, if you experience a build error during build, like so, what you're going to probably do as your first step is actually click on the build button again to see if it takes care of the problem. If you do experience a problem a third time, go to the very first error that you experience and correct the issue. So this is going to take a few moments to actually build, but we're going to have to go back to the workbench and adjust the actual hardware. So once we do that, we're going to load our build next. So I'll show you the steps to that process in just a second. I just want to make sure that this builds correctly. And once this is finished, we'll actually have our build up here in the .pio build folder for the Bigtree Tech. So if you look right here and you right click on firmware.bin and reveal in File Explorer, you can actually see our firmware.bin for our binary. So let me bring that up so you can actually see it. So this is the actual firmware.bin. So let's go over to the workbench for a second and get this configured. So on the workbench, I'm going to pick up the actual stepper driver. Now notice there's yellow on one side and black on the other. That's a key to installing this. And all the jumpers should be in place currently. So your board comes default with the jumpers in a certain position. That's SPI for serial peripheral interface. So I'm going to take this and I'm actually going to insert it right here. So the black side is going to be on the right. And then I'm going to push it down. So now that that's installed, we're all set there. But we do need to install our actual NEMA stepper. So I'm going to plug this in. Now, I'm not going to plug in end stops at the moment because I just want to show you how it works. So I'm going to slide this over. The other thing that I want to do is actually set it up for power. So as you can see, I've marked these for power. Now, if you look through them, red is for voltage and black is for ground or unmarked. Now, one of these down here is actually incorrect that a user pointed out for the heat bed. And the reason that it's incorrect is that the polarity that I have marked here of red and black might be reversed, but technically when you're running without a MOSFET, it's okay. But when you are running with the MOSFET, it does matter or may matter. So what we're gonna do next is actually set up the actual power for the steppers. So I'm gonna do the first setup here. And I'm going to slide in black, and then I'm going to tighten it down, and then I'm going to do the same for red, and tighten that down. Then I'm going to do the same for the board logic, which is over here. And before we power this up, we're actually going to check the diagram. Now, the underside of the board also has the markings for positive and negative. Positive is actually voltage. So there is a way to verify underneath, but I'm going to put this down for safety. The other thing that I'm going to do is remove this jumper so that we can load the firmware via the power supply. And in this case, I'm using a power supply for 12 volts, but in certain instances, you may need to adjust in your advanced configuration your power supply if it's not 12 volts. So now that we have that set up, let's go back over and check on the actual configuration that we have for this board and see if we can see where positive and negative is. Unfortunately, it's not going to be easily visible. So here's the actual board, and they don't actually mark positive and negative on top. So you're probably going to have to verify underneath, but they do have this little key down here where you see GND for ground, and then you see bed. So this is positive and negative. Then it's positive for 24 volts or negative for ground. Now the board will function on either 12 or 24 volts, but I just want to make you aware of where you can verify these things. So let's go back and actually set up the firmware load. So I'm going to go back over to the workbench for a second. I'm going to grab the drive out of here and I'm going to plug it into the USB device so that we can actually load it on the drive and plug this into the computer. Then I'm going to go back over to the folder that we opened with the firmware. So let's take a look at that and right click on that and send it to our E drive. So on the E drive, I'll show you something real quick. It says firmware .cur in all capital letters. What that means is that that was the last current firmware load that occurred. Above is firmware.bin. Once this loads, it will be converted to this. And cur in this case is not actually a cursor file. It's a notation that they use with the file name to say current. So if you were ever to want to reload this firmware on maybe another board, you'd rename it to firmware.bin. So let's go back over to the board and set this up. So on the board, what we need to do now is actually power it once we plug in the SD drive. So here's the drive. I'm going to plug this in here. I'm also going to plug in my USB because currently it's not providing power. And then I'm going to plug in the actual power. So always modify your board without the power connected. So let's plug that in and see what happens. So you're going to probably see a flashing light, which means that the firmware is actually loading. And so the next thing that we're going to have to do is actually test this. So what I'm going to have to do is actually open up Pronerface in order to test this. So once Pronerface is open, we'll go and look, and right now it's defaulted to the COM port 9. If in fact we wanted to check that, what we could do is this. We can type device manager, and inside here it'll bring up device manager, and we can actually check to see what it is. In this case, it's COM port 9. COM port 1 is default to your computer. So what we're going to do now is actually connect and see if this works. And it says printer is now online. So now there is a debug that we can type called M122 for a G code that'll show us the status of our stepper to make sure it's installed right. So currently it says everything is okay right here. So let's try and move it. So I'm going to move it 10 millimeters to see how it works. And it works correctly. Let's try the other direction. So let's try 100 in this direction. So that's pretty good. So just in case you don't know, if it's moving in the direction that's not optimal for you, you can check on inverting the stepper on configuration.h. And that should help you set up the opposite direction. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.